It appears to be the state's theory that Rob had this firearm, somehow, after being handcuffed, shot himself and freed himself of these handcuffs. The problem with that theory is that no gunshot residue was ever found on Rob's right hand.
So without gunshot residue on the right-hand glove or his right hand, the one he would have needed to shoot his own left hand, it can be said with certainty that he had not fired the gun at all. Someone else was at that crime scene firing a gun.